Hello my dear students, good morning to all of you. In today's session we'll discuss on a very important topic, that is Paschen's law. Okay, in the previous class we have already discussed about the various theories, also the breakdown mechanism in the presence of the gaseous dielectric medium. There are two theories are there. Which are those two theories? One, it is the Townsend's theory, and one more is the streamer theory, right? So those two theories which can be well explained the mechanism of a breakdown process in the presence of the gaseous dielectric media. And very important thing is here, according to this Paschen's law, the breakdown voltage, getting my point, the minimum voltage at which the breakdown of the gaseous dielectric media takes place. So that voltage, it is mainly depends upon the two factors. So what are those factors, in the sense that, for example, different gaseous dielectric medias are going to be used between the two electrodes, is it right? So the gas, whatever the gas, examples like what? Oxygen is there, carbon dioxide, sulfur hexafluoride, and even air, it is also going to be acts like a perfect insulator, is it right? So that gas pressure is very important. The breakdown voltage of any gaseous dielectric media depends upon the two factors. Which are those? One is the gas pressure, that is represented by a P, and one more factor is the distance or the gap between the two electrodes. Getting my point? So we can say that the breakdown voltage of a gaseous dielectric medium, so this is the function of a gas pressure as well as the gap between the two electrodes. Getting my point? So let us see what exactly the Paschen's law now. See here. So this is the derivation for the Paschen's law. See, first thing here, let me consider the equation. So what we had studied in a previous class, the breakdown criterion for the breakdown mechanism criterion. What is the formula for that one? So that is, in the previous class also we have discussed about the Townsend's criterion for breakdown. Just you go through those. So what the equation we have derived in the previous class, that only I had taken into consideration in this. Okay, so this will be the breakdown criterion in the gaseous dielectric media. So that will be given by how? Gamma into the bracket of exponential of alpha into d minus 1, bracket complete, this will be equal to 1 itself. In the previous class, the Townsend's mechanism for breakdown, getting my point, the Townsend's criterion for breakdown, in that derivation we have derived this equation. You just go through that one. So that equation only I had taken in this. Okay, so this, there is a gamma, it is nothing but what? This is the Townsend's secondary ionization coefficient, where alpha is the Townsend's primary ionization coefficient, and d is the distance between the two electrodes. Okay, so where these two coefficients, which are those two coefficients, one is alpha and one more is the gamma itself. So these two coefficients are the functions of what I told here, functions of the gas pressure as well as the applied electrical field itself. That is why I am going to take here. So these two coefficients are the functions of a ratio of electrical field to the gas pressure. Okay, so now how we'll write now equations. So first we'll consider the Townsend's primary ionization coefficient. So this is the function of E divided by P. So that only I have written here. So alpha divided by P, nothing but the gas pressure, this will be equal to function of, that is why F1 of E divided by P here. And even this Townsend secondary ionization coefficient, that is represented as a gamma. So this is also a function of what? E divided by P itself. So that is why how I have written here, gamma is equal to F2, or the function of E divided by P it is. Getting? And also the applied uniform electrical field between the electrodes, this will be the ratio of what? Voltage, that is the breakdown voltage to the distance between the electrodes. This E will be given by V divided by D it is. Getting my point? So now what I will do? So now substituting this E value in the expressions for what? Alpha as well as the gamma. Okay, then how we'll write now? So alpha divided by p, as it is I had written here. So this is the function of f1 of e, in the sense that what it is there? This is v divided by d. So instead of this e, I will substitute v divided by d. So I can write like this, is it right? F1 into the bracket of v divided by p into d. So call this equation as a 2. Next thing here. So now this value of e, I will substitute for the coefficient gamma also. So gamma is equal to f2 of into the bracket of e, means what I can substitute now? V divided by d itself. So that only I had substituted here. E, instead of this e, v divided by p, v divided by d into p it is there. Is it right? So call this equation as a 3 itself. Okay. Now what I will do? You can observe the equation number 1. So this is the breakdown criterion in the gases itself. Now I got the equations for alpha as well as the gamma, right? So now I will substitute these two coefficients in the equation 1 itself. Getting? So now you substitute in the first equation. I had written the first equation, what it is there? Gamma into the bracket of exponential of alpha into d minus 1. So this is equal to 1 it is there. Is it right? So in this equation, I will substitute the equation 2 and 3. So these equation 2 and 3 represents the equations for the coefficients like alpha and gamma it is there. Is it right? So now gamma is nothing but what? Gamma is equal to f2. So this only I had substituted here. Gamma is nothing but function of f2 of v divided by pd into the bracket of exponential of alpha. It is nothing but what? From this equation, how we'll write the alpha? So alpha is equal to p into f1 into the bracket of v divided by pd. Is it right? So that only I had written here. So alpha, instead of this alpha, p f1 v divided by pd as it is there, but along with the multiplied, one more d is there. That is why I had written it as a pd f1 into the bracket of v divided by pd. So minus 1, this is equal to 1 it is. Is it right? Call this equation as a 4 it is there. So now the above equation, what, which is that equation? The equation number 4, it will give the relationship between what? Breakdown voltage as well as the p into d. So earlier thing, what I told here, the Paschen's law, according to the Paschen's law, the breakdown voltage of a gaseous dielectric medium, so that will be depends upon the two factors. Which are those I told? So the one is the gas pressure. Whatever might be the gaseous medium, we are going to use as a dielectric medium in case of a two electrode system, right? So which are those gases? Any gaseous medium you take, either it is a oxygen, carbon dioxide or sulfur hexafluoride, any gaseous dielectric medium you consider. Okay, so the breakdown voltage, that will be depends upon the gas pressure. Getting my point? So one is a gas pressure, one more is the distance between the two electrodes. Getting my point? So this breakdown voltage is directly proportional to the product of a p into d itself. Getting my point? So the breakdown voltage varies as the product of the p into d varies. So we can write, so can we write like this now? So the breakdown voltage v is the function of p into d. From this equation we can say easily, right? So obviously the breakdown voltage, it will be depends upon the gas pressure as well as the distance between two electrodes, right? So this is going to be, this equation, it is going to be, call it as what? Paschen's law. I hope this is clear to all of you. Okay, now, so now let us consider the Paschen's curve. So Paschen's curve, in the sense that the relationship between the breakdown voltage and the product of gas pressure and the distance between electrode. Okay, see this diagram. So this is the curve. Which curve? So this is the curve for what? Paschen's law, or it is also going to be called it as a Paschen's curve. So this is the curve between which are those factors? Breakdown voltage as well as the product of gas pressure and the distance between electrodes. Is it right? So this diagram, this curve, we can say that the relationship between this voltage and the product PD is not linear. From this curve, we can say that the relationship between this breakdown voltage as well as the product of gas pressure and the distance between electrode, which is not linear. Getting my point? And it has a minimum value, Vs minimum, and it has a minimum value for any gaseous dielectric media. Getting my point? So that means what here in the x-axis, what I had considered here, that is the product P into D. So P in the sense that pressure, that is expressed in a torr itself, and the distance, and the distance unit is centimeter I had taken here. The product of P into D, that is expressed in torr centimeter, and this is the breakdown voltage V I had written here. Getting my point? By seeing this curve, we can say that the relationship between this voltage and the product PD, which is not linear, by this curve we can say, is it right? And it will be having the minimum value, which value? That is breakdown voltage, that is represented by Vs minimum for any gas itself, any gas in the sense that either it may be a carbon dioxide or it is oxygen or it may be sulfur hexafluoride, is it right? So now, so this means that what, the breakdown voltage, the breakdown voltage of a uniform field gap, uniform field gap in the sense that the distance between the two electrodes, it is the function of a product of P as well as the distance between the electrodes. Getting my point? For a particular gas or for a given electrode material itself. Getting my point? So this is all about what? Paschen's curve. So the Paschen curve is the relationship between which are the factors. One is the breakdown voltage and one more is the product of a P into D itself. Getting? So now, from this Paschen's law, the breakdown voltage of a spark gap. So the breakdown voltage of a spark gap, so written, that can be written in terms of a two coefficients. Which are those two coefficients? That is Townsend's primary ionization coefficient represented by alpha and the Townsend secondary ionization coefficient represented by gamma itself. So this breakdown voltage we can express in terms of these two coefficients. So now let us consider the equation for the distance between the two electrodes by taking into consideration of which are those coefficients, alpha as well as the gamma. So how we will write the equation now? D equal to 1 divided by alpha. This is the ln of into the bracket of 1 plus 1 divided by gamma it is. Getting my point? And we know that alpha and gamma are the functions of what? E divided by P it is there. So how we will write now? Alpha divided by P, which is the function of E divided by P. And this gamma is also a function of this ratio. Is it right? Gamma is equal to function of or F2 of E divided by P. And the electrical field, that will be given by V divided by D itself. Is it right? So these three equations we know already. Is it right? So now, so those equations only I will substitute in the equation for the gap between the two electrodes. How we'll write now? So D equal to 1 divided by alpha means alpha, how we'll write from this equation? Alpha is equal to, when we take into the RHS side, alpha is equal to P into F1 into the bracket of E divided by P. Is it right? So E means what it is there? V divided by D itself. Instead of this E, I can substitute V divided by P into D it is there. Is it right? So that only I had written now. D is equal to 1 divided by alpha in the sense that P into F1 into the bracket of E means V divided by D. So V divided by P into D itself. Getting? So next thing here, into ln of into the bracket of 1 plus 1 divided by gamma is nothing but what? Function of E divided by P. Instead of this E, I can substitute V divided by D, right? So F2 of V divided by P into D. Is it right? So this will give the equation for what? The distance between the two electrodes in terms of which coefficients? Alpha as well as the gamma. Okay. So now alpha, now what we'll do? Now for this coefficient, that is Townsend's primary ionization coefficient. Now this alpha may be assumed to follow an exponential function. Let us assume that this coefficient alpha, it will follows the exponential function. How we'll write this one? So what we had assumed now, alpha is equal to A, it is nothing but the constant, that is exponential constant A, into P is nothing but the gas pressure, exponential of this is b is also a constant. A and b are the exponential constants itself, and this p is the gas pressure with respect to the applied uniform electric field. Okay, alpha is equal to a into p exponential of minus b into p divided by e itself, where e is nothing but what, v divided by d, is it right? So instead of this e, I can substitute now v divided by d, right? So rewrite this equation, what you will get, alpha is equal to a into p exponential of r e raised to minus b p, I had written as it is, instead of this e, what I had substituted, v divided by d itself, is it right? V, e means v divided by t. When we take the reciprocality, it will be d divided by v it is. Is it right? So this will be the exponential. Alpha is the coefficient, alpha is nothing but the Townsend's primary ionization coefficient. What we assumed, we assume it as a exponential function, and we have written like this, is it right? Alpha is equal to a into p e raised to minus bp into d divided by v it is. So this is for the alpha. Okay, so now substituting, next what you will do, substitute this coefficient alpha in the equation d itself, where the equation d is there, the equation number 6. So this alpha you substitute in the equation number 6 itself. So how will write the equation now? So substitute this alpha value in this. So d is equal to 1 divided by alpha means a into p e raised to minus bp into d divided by v into the bracket of ln of 1 plus 1 divided by gamma. So that only I had substituted and written like this. Okay. So now from this equation I can get the equation for the breakdown voltage, right? So the breakdown voltage V equal to, how will write now? So this breakdown voltage V I will take into the LHS side. How will write? What is remaining now here? BP into D, that is on the numerator side here. So here this exponential term, when you take this side, means it will be the ln of a into p into d divided by, what is remaining term is there, ln of 1 plus 1 divided by gamma. So this is the equation for the breakdown voltage, which is the function of a very important factors. One is the gas pressure and the distance between the electrodes. Getting my point? So the minimum value for this V or the breakdown voltage, that is going to be obtained by making what? So differentiate this voltage, breakdown voltage, with respect to the product of pressure as well as the distance between electrodes. So dV divided by d into the bracket of PD, then equate it to 0. You will get it as a this PD minimum value after differentiating with respect to the PD product, and we equate it to 0 means you will get the equations like this. Okay, so what we will get, PD minimum equal to E divided by A ln of 1 plus 1 divided by gamma, and the voltage minimum breakdown voltage will get it as a E into B divided by A ln of 1 plus 1 divided by gamma, where E value is 2.178 it is. Getting? So and one more curve I had represented here. So this is the breakdown voltage as a function of a PD only. So but which gas we had considered now here? Sulfur hexafluoride gas it is. Getting my point? So from this figure we can say that at a higher values of a PD, so P in the sense that pressure, what is the unit of pressure, it is torr it is there, and the distance unit will be centimeter. So this unit of this product PD is torr centimeter, and this breakdown voltage in terms of a kilo volts it is. Getting my point? From this curve, so the which gas we had considered? So the breakdown voltage, which is the function of a PD by considering the sulfur hexafluoride gaseous dielectric media. Is it right? So here, so from this figure, at a higher values of PD, at higher values of PD, so the breakdown voltage, this is the breakdown voltage in some gases, which is found that slightly higher than the values for the smaller gaps. Getting my point? Whenever the distance between the two electrodes, if it is smaller, means the breakdown voltage is found to be slightly higher than the values of a PD itself. Getting my point? So next thing here, this departure from this Paschen's law is probably, it is nothing but the from transition from Townsend's breakdown mechanism to the streamer mechanism. Getting my point? So that this departure from this Paschen's law, we can say that it is the transition from which criteria? From Townsend's breakdown mechanism to the streamer mechanism, that we already discussed, right? So we can, from this curve, we can say it like that. Getting my point? On the other hand, suppose if it is at a lower pressure, the gaseous pressure, if it is low, in that case, what will happen? The deviations from this Paschen's law, if it is going to be observed like a, when the breakdown mechanism, if it is not influenced by the properties of a gas. So properties of the gas, in the sense that either it is a gas pressure or the temperature, is it right? Or the electrode field configuration or the nature of the electrodes, is it right? Suppose if the gas pressure is low, in that case, this deviations from this Paschen's law, it is observed that when the breakdown mechanism, which is not influenced by the properties of a gas, but it will be depends upon the purity as well as the property of the electrodes. Getting my point? So this is all about what it is, the Paschen's curve. The Paschen's curve is the relationship between the breakdown voltage as well as the function of a P into D, it is there. So which gaseous medium we had considered here? That is sulfur hexafluoride. Getting my point? So this is all about the Paschen's law. Only thing is that you need to remember, Paschen's law is nothing but the according to this law, the breakdown voltage, in the sense that we already studied about the two electrode system, is it right? So two electrode system, when we apply the voltage, the electrons are going to be starts moving from cathode to the anode itself, is it right? In between these two electrodes, there is a small distance. This distance, it is occupied with the gaseous dielectric media, right? So whenever we apply the higher voltage, the electrons are going to be starts moving from cathode to the anode itself. Getting my point? So when we apply a higher voltage, then what will happen? That results into an increased amount of the current flow, is it right? Huge amount of the current will flow from cathode to the anode itself. Due to this increased or due to the high amount of flow of a current, then what will happen? The insulating media or the dielectric media present between the two electrodes gets breakdown, is it right? So that is why, according to this Paschen's law, what it is there? The breakdown voltage, which is mainly the function or the breakdown voltage of any different gaseous dielectric materials, it is going to varies. When it is going to vary, or we can say that it will be completely, breakdown voltage is the function of a gas pressure, and one more factor is the distance between the two electrodes. Or else simple equation for this Paschen's law is the breakdown voltage V equal to F of P into D. So keep it in mind, okay? The breakdown voltage V will be the function of a P into D itself. So this is all about what? Paschen's law. I hope this is clear to all of you, okay? Thank you.